Pizza break. Anyway, where were we? Something about this game being awesome. Something about how games. Something about this game being awesome. Oh, better go get that Riddler. Gonna go ahead and since we, you know, like we gotta complete access to Gotham City here and all now. Oh, thank gosh. I was so terrified that he's accidentally gonna do the takedown on the Riddler guy. Fuck you, don't run, you pussy. Gonna take this chance to talk about, Founder's Island here.
You can stay loyal to Riddler, or you can stay in one piece.
Whatever you want!
The right choice.
Founder's Island is my favorite island because holy shit, look at how fucking cool it is.
There he is.
Now, obviously, it's called Founder's Island, so we can presume that it's the first island that the colonists settled when they first came to Gotham City. And you can even implicate some kind of backstory about maybe a Jamestown kind of scenario between the founders here on Founders Island and the Miyagani people living on Miyagani Island right across the river there. Yes, we have. So the nifty part about Founders Island, as you can see, is it's kind of eternally under construction. As you can see, originally, the island back in the day, at some point, you can implicate a lot about the like timeline here, but originally, it was... Like, obviously, this roof wasn't always here. Down here was, like, street level. So try and imagine this environment without the roof overhead here. And back in its heyday, when all of these buildings were actually... No, I didn't mean to do that! Fuck! When all of these, buildings were open. In fact, one of the riddles, fuck you, that I got earlier over here is the Cobblepot Mansion. Compare the Cobblepot, like, Cobblepot, the Penguin's family. Are like Gotham royalty alongside the Waynes. These are like the founding families. Cobblepot, Wayne, all these important families. And this is where their mansion was set up. You can sort of imagine Cobblepot Manor as being something of a center of activity in the same way that Wayne Manor was. And since it's here in the city, it probably had a more direct influence over the development. But now, as you can see, over time, Founders Island had become something of a slum. A real prey slum, just squirrels and mice living all over the place. You had to go all the way across the bridge to get here and hunt them down. It just started becoming a huge problem for everyone. That's a good idea. You could take Founders Island down here, at least, as a real frame of reference for what prey slums look like. That's amusing to me now. Look at this abandoned cinema. The Osiris movie theater. Look, it's so old that they've still got the posters for the Ghost in the Gray hanging up. That's a good measure of time you can take for how long ago Founders Island really started to enter its degenerative state. Oh, it's sort of on the same time frame as the Panchaea movie studio, which I've already talked about.
Oh man, it's him! Don't worry, he ain't catching us! Oh god,
fuck you. So then at some point, Bruce Wayne, apparently, was like, this is bullshit. Like, come on, guys. But, like, you can sort of imagine him going like, come on. And everyone else in Gotham City is like, yeah, yeah. So they started reconstruction, but this says a lot of the mentality of Gotham City as a community. They didn't pave over everything that was here. They didn't, like, tear it down. They built on top of it. Literally. They literally made an artificial ground level on top of the buildings that were already here. I really wish I could turn off the fucking... Oh, I'll just take off my headphones. There you go. I won't have to be distracted by it. They literally built a ground floor on top of what was here before. Like, over top of the building. And you can actually see here, like, the buildings were already here. They already were this tall. And they only bothered to renovate the part of the building that was above ground. Everything that's underneath, they left to this disarray. But then above ground, they said, like, let's go ahead and build... Look at this! It's so interesting to think about that. And most of this island is still under construction, too. Like, they're still building it. See here, this bridge. It's not even... This island, Founders Island, isn't even connected to the monorail system that the rest of the island has going for it. My moment draws near. They're still in the process of building a bridge to connect Founders Island to the rest of the city. So then, what buildings are already here built up on top of the old Gotham that came before? Obviously, this isn't very hospitable for, everyday living. And when you think about it philosophically, what kind of culture would not even pave over, not even get rid of, not even blow up and build on top of the ashes? God damn it. They literally just, like, slapped a second floor on top of what was once there and built on top of it. It's the corporations, the banks, the big businesses. This is the Wall Street of Gotham City. And here's the monorail system. I was wrong. This is the Wall Street. You've even got the Gotham Stock Exchange right there next to LexCorp, next to Queen Industries, next to the Wayne Foundation building in the back. This is the, like, the bank district. This is the business district. This is the district that folks wake up in their, like, the white collar affluent society. They don't live here, but they wake up in their apartments or houses and they take the monorail here and get out and go into their building and clock in and check into their cubicles every day. That's the kind of island Founders Island is. The wealthy corporation, not even like personal wealth in the form of Bruce Wayne and even the Penguin to a minor degree. Not old money, it's new money. It's the corporate business world. It's the... Like, that's two very different kinds of wealth when you think about it. There's the personal wealth of the playboy philanthropist, of the Richie Rich type of character, of the Bruce Wayne type of character, and then there's the corporate wealth. which I think is best personified by a character like Lex Luthor. The kind of business ethics that sees people as disposable in the pursuit of profit, of corporate interest, of shares, that kind of thing. That's the kind of people, that's the kind of cluster, of group that would think, let's just slap a fucking roof over old Gotham and build on top of it. That's really fucking interesting, isn't it? And again, even more so considering this is Founder's Island. This is where Gotham City started. This is where the Pilgrims landed and started building what would become Gotham City. Nicely.
This is all I know!
Thanks.
Really fucking interesting, I think. Like, Founder's Island is by far my favorite island. But that's enough about that. Let's go and deal with a nocturnal annoyance over here. Haven't seen our old buddy Man-Bat in a while. Hey, there's only enough room for one bat to perch around Wayne Enterprises, buddy. Let's deal with this. Haven't seen you in a while. Hopefully, we can go ahead and fix you up here. This silly comic book fucking science of splicing bats into your DNA, turning you into a bat. That's just fucking weird.
I've captured Dr. Langstrom and administered the cure. I need you to prep an isolation chamber. I'm bringing him in.
Sure thing. I'll get right on it.
Don't think we're gonna have a backseat conversation with this guy.
No way,
all things considered.
No way. Even if it is.
Kinda weird that this character we've had the side quests for from the beginning of the game almost, and you really only get the chance to finally finish it off at this point. By now, with all that's happened, a lot of players might have forgotten about Langstrom flying around out there, since you could progress so much of his side quest so early on in the game. But you're only really allowed to complete it right now after you finish at Panchay Studio, when a lot has happened. Can you give the guy a fucking jacket or something?
Just when I think I've seen it all. He gonna be okay?
Physically, yes.
Where's Francine? Where is she?
She's dead, Kirk.
No! I didn't. What have I done?
The serum. It changed you. You lost control.
What have I done?
At least they got him some pants.
I'm sorry, Kirk, but this is the right place for you.
I only wanted to help people, and I've killed the one thing I ever loved.
It wasn't you that did those things. I believe you never meant to harm anyone.
But I did. Nothing can change that. I'm a freak, a monster. They should leave me to rot in here.
It just occurred to me. Kirky Baby didn't have a choice. But you actually choose to be a flying rodent. It's genius.
I didn't want this. You have to believe me. My beautiful wife. I loved her more than anything.
Poor old Kirk here is kind of self-explanatory. Not really a lot of interesting analyses to take to it. Just your everyday tragedy. It is nice that man gets some rep in the game here, considering, again, in the very first episode of Batman the Animated Series, it was Man-Bat.
Still no word from Gordon. I'm worried, Batman. He swore he'd never let anyone ever hurt her again. He won't forgive himself.
I think I love her, Batman. I love Poison Ivy.
Yes. I've never felt like this before. We've got new dialogue quite... Oh, wait.
Owens over there. They moved him out the cell. He seems to be doing better.
There you go. Owens, you're finally better. How you doing, buddy? We didn't see it coming in. Because of Kirk.
I thought for sure she was going to stab us in the back.
Because we came in with Kirk, we didn't get to see. The cell's empty. Check that out. Maybe we can put some actual criminals in here now? No? The cell's just going to remain empty for the entire rest of the game? Okay. That makes sense. Whatever.
I think I'm one of the only ones left who thinks Gordon's still alive. Even Cash is losing hope.
To be fair, we haven't seen him in a while.
He's still off comms. What if he does something stupid?
He wouldn't do that.
You know that for certain? He's lost everything. The city, his daughter. He's gonna be hurting bad. Yeah, Gordon's old school. He's seen it all. But this... it's too much for him. The longer it goes on...
Something in me says he's still out there. I don't see him taking that way out. That's not his style.
Times like this, I'm glad I don't have any kids. Just an extra worry I don't need.
I think I'm one of the only...
Okay, yeah, we do have some new dialogue here.
Doesn't seem real, Batman.
Let's go around and see if we can get some new barks.
Tonight we really found out who's willing to stand up and be counted. Not too many by my count.
Again, it reminds me of Death Note. There's a part in Death Note where they're like, okay, we are dealing with some supernatural bullshit. Like, this guy can just kill you, and it's fucked up. And the police are like, okay, we kind of don't want to have to deal with this. Like, come on, guys. And so they start a special task force that's solely dedicated to dealing with the villain in Death Note. And the leader, like, the head police dude is like, okay, I'm going to leave the room. And anyone who's still in the room when I come back is part of the task force. Anyone who's not in the room, no judgment, no nothing bad to say about that. I understand. Nothing needs to be said. If you don't want to put your life on the line, you just leave, and that's the end of that. And so he comes back, and it's like fucking seven dudes. And he's like, only seven. And then he corrects himself, and he's like, no. I should say, as many as seven brave men are willing to put their lives on the line to deal with this threat. So that's how I feel about it, you know? I mean, fuck it. Oh, not many by my count. As many as this many people were willing to put their lives on the line to be here in this hour of crisis, they should be commended. I wouldn't do it.
I made a promise to myself. I'm getting through this. Whatever it takes.
Fuck that. I'd be fucking gone. This shit's bullshit. Especially Gotham City. Why would you even live in Gotham City? At all.
Where the hell does someone like Scarecrow get an army?
Maybe Bruce Wayne funded it. Scarecrow destroys the place, then Wayne gets the contracts when they have to rebuild.
Yeah. Bet that guy's living it up in some fancy resort by now. It's not right. Gordon's given his life to this city. He doesn't deserve this. I didn't think things could get any worse around here. Then we hear about Barbara.
Hey, there's some familiar faces. It's the Piggies. How you doing, Piggies?
What's him do that to those people? I can't get it out of my head.
Do we have to be in here with him looking at us? It's making me feel sick.
Yeah, again. What the fuck is with this maximum security bullshit? It's just a farce. Come on, you guys. That's ridiculous.
What is with that freaking opera? My wife's got tickets to La Boheme. She can forget that.
I will take those tickets. I will take those tickets right now. You give me those fucking tickets. You fucking give me those tickets, buddy. You think I won't kill you? I have a crazy clown in my head.
I don't want to be in the same room as that guy. Hell, not even the same country.
What makes someone want to do that to another person, Batman? What the hell's happened to him?
He was probably abused by his mom or something like that.
Please tell me he's never getting out. I need to know that that thing in there is gonna rot in jail.
Pig really strikes me as the kind of guy who had a real fucking Binding of Isaac backstory. So just play Binding of Isaac, and that kid grew up into Professor Pig. That's my headcanon.
I saw those people out in the cells. The ones he changed?
It's horrible. They'd be better off dead.
Is that your professional medical opinion?
I shut my eyes earlier. Must have dozed off. I was right back there, seeing it, hearing the screams.
Eh, you'll get over it. Hey, speaking of severe mental trauma, how you holding up, buddy? How's it hanging, bud? Hey, champ. Hey, sport. How's it hanging?
Oh, I've had bad hangovers, but this, it's 1,000 times worse.
I almost like his dialogue when you kill people on the opening more, because with this, it sounds like he's a little bit over it. Like, it wasn't traumatic enough.
Everyone's keeping their distance. Can't say I blame him. I probably would as well.
And I don't know why he's putting in a performance with gravelly voice like that. Is he trying to imitate Batman?
Do you know if there are any side effects? The paramedics here can't tell me anything.
The paramedics here can't tell me anything.
One of the guys filmed me on his phone. Watched it back. Couldn't believe it was me. It sounded like a different person.
Yeah, obviously, if you play at the very, very beginning of the game in the diner when the shit's going down and you shoot some guys and kill them, his dialogue is different here.
Everyone's keeping their distance.
And he's like, fucked up. He's like, oh my god, I killed people. What the fuck? My career's over. I feel so guilty having taken human life. Blah, 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 blah. And personally, I think it's a lot more compelling than the dialogue he gets just from, you know, being fine like this,
I'm
basically.
I'm thinking of writing Ivy a note. You know, writing down my feelings. I think that's the best thing, don't you? Can you get paper that's not made from trees?
Parchment is made from, animal hide.
I think I love her, Batman. I love poison ivy.
Blah, 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 we're ignoring you.
I've never felt like this before.
Let's go get some updates in here.
One modified flare gun. One machine gun haphazardly duct-taped to a grenade launcher. And one good old-fashioned baseball bat. All used by Dr. Harlene Quinzel, a.k.a. Harley Quinn. Without Joker around, Harley took over the clown's old gang. It was never gonna last. One modified
flare gun.
One pig mask and butcher's knife. Used by Laszlo Valentine, a.k.a. Professor Pig. This guy's new. Mutilates his victims in order to make them perfect. I think I'm pretty enough already, thanks.
Did they tape the mask back together?
One hell of a lot of money. Stolen from various bank accounts.
We're not quite done with Two-Face yet.
One vial of unknown chemical substance and one vampire bat. Owned by Kirk Langstrom, a.k.a. What are we gonna call this guy? Batman's already taken. I guess this guy's more of a man bat anyway.
There you go. Already got that. Militia. Okay. You know what? Let's go fill up the maximum security cell a little bit more, why don't we? We got room. We got room for everybody in there. Let's just shove all of the supervillains in the same cell right in the middle of fucking HQ. Fucking so stupid.
Concentration of forces shifting between Miyagani and Founders.
They were waiting to strike, right underneath our damn streets.
There's been talk about exacting a little retribution on the prisoners. That's all it is at the moment. Just talk. Hopefully it stays that way.
Whatever you're doing out there, they don't like it.
The militia must have been planning this for months.
Hearing about Barbara? It's hit everyone pretty hard here. Never seen Cash so torn up about something.
Concentration of forces shifting.
They were waiting to strike.
There's been talk about exacting a little retribution on the prisoners.
There we go.
That's all it is.
Okay, so that's all the new dialogue. Hopefully it stays that way. We'll be... Well, actually, no, it's not. There's more officers out here. And hey, speaking of crazy religious fanatics...
Got my hands on this forensic report. Human sacrifice. It's real. They're really happening. The deceased M. Hollis, located in the abandoned premises, front-facing room to hem and clothes. Male, 33 years, approximately 6 feet, 210 pounds, brown hair. Found lying face up on a table central to the room. Contusions on the wrist and ankles, indicating the victim was restrained with a thick cord or rope. The neck has been cut, deep incision severing the esophagus and main arteries. The body appears to have been drained of blood. Victim is naked. Clothes have been burned as well as personal effects. No sign of murder weapon. Symbols have been drawn onto the walls in victim's blood. Photographs locked. Scene secured by Detective Russo at 2100 hours. Something big's happening. Blackfire's here, I know it. He wants that final sacrifice, but where? I need that last piece of the puzzle, then bam!
Tell me what you're doing.
Sounds bad out there, Batman. Rather you than me.
Agreed.
I'm guessing you've encountered a few religious cults in your time. What's your take on them?
They prey on the weak and the vulnerable.
Sounds like my ex-wife's lawyer.
Whatever you're up to, stop.
Trust me, I'm hands off on this one. Cross my heart.
Tape 25, October 30th. Got my hands on this forensic.
How's the commissioner
report?
Holding up? Human, you think you could get me an interview?
It's real.
Too soon?
They're really happy.
How about in a couple of hours?
The deceased M. Hollis.
You been over to see where it happened? You know, where Gordon's kid died? You could get me access, right?
What the fuck is wrong with you, Jack? 210 pounds,
brown hair. They'll thank me one day. You wait and see. Jack Ryder was the one who risked everything to uncover the truth.
Fuck you, Jack. What do you guys have to say?
No car. Just me and you, Batman. Anytime you want.
Whatever.
Knight's gonna have his hands around your throat again, Batman. Next time he's finishing the job.
That new suit don't look so new anymore, Batman. Looks like you're having some trouble. Take the night off. You know you wanna.
You've pissed off the Penguin one too many times, Batman. He's gonna make you pay.
You can't stop us, Batman. That money's ours. I don't see no customers left around here to claim it.
You're never gonna win this war. It's over for you.
Scarecrow can't keep that cloudburst hidden forever. We just gotta pray you're around to stop him when it shows up. I thought about joining the army once, but when it came down to it, I knew deep down I was not a soldier. So I became a cop. Much safer.
The Arkham Knight must have a convincing argument for invading a city. He ain't short of recruits.
It's all about the money with these guys. They're mercs.
Money aside, I think some of them really believe what they're doing. That's the scary part.
One good thing. Owen seems to be getting better. They've moved him from the cells. At least we know that stuff wears off.
Yeah, after like fucking 5 hours.
Someone's got to break it to him what's been happening around here. Probably gonna wish he was still crazy.
So yeah, Here are the Dolatrons. Kinda sad that we're not getting them medical attention, all things considered, but situation's a bit, foobar at the moment, so I suppose I understand. We'll get around to it tomorrow, I guess. Appropriate that we're having such a fucking horror show on fucking Halloween, though, right?
We're not short of men willing to take you down, Batman. Everyone wants a piece.
How many wars have you fought, Batman? This army knows how to survive. Do you?
Gordon won't stop. He's gonna hunt them down. Every last one. Who can blame him? If we catch Scarecrow, we should make an example of him. Hang him off Mercy Bridge. I like the irony.
Nah, by the book, buddy. Always by the book. How's my favorite sergeant?
You sure it's safe having Ivy out there on her own growing God knows what? It always starts with a couple of plants. Before you know it, Gotham's a rainforest. I spoke to my daughter, told her I was okay and that I'd see her soon. I hope those words turn out to be true. We can't give up. That's what they want. They want the world to see it's hopeless. Well, I don't believe that. There's always hope.
I fucking love you, Sergeant Hanrahan.
You sure it's safe having Ivy out there on her own growing God knows
I thought
what?
It was bad before. Now Barbara's gone. Some of the guys around here are going to be looking for revenge, Batman.
Scarecrow's enjoying this.
He's toying with us.
This is like one big experiment.
There are some good cops in here, Batman.
I mean it. They're really looking out for each other.
She meant a lot to me, too. But it's wrong. I ain't afraid to say it. I'll tell them to their face if I have to.
Never thought we'd be relying on Ivy for help. The officer in charge here, Cash, I think his name is, he doesn't seem too pleased.
I don't mean to be a glass half-empty guy, but I think this is all gonna get a hell of a lot worse before it gets better. I wish I could shake this feeling. Just feel like something awful's coming.
Personally, I don't care who helps as long as we stop that gas from being released. You could drag Joker back in here for all I care. Might help if he was still breathing. You get the idea.
Well, if anyone could help, it would probably be Joker. He's something of a chemical mastermind himself, I guess.
I hate not being out there. Just letting them win like this? Picking us off one by one?
It's not right, Commissioner being out there on his own. You know,
don't tell me we're pinning all our hopes on a giant plant. Oh, man. We are, aren't we?
You gotta find Scarecrow. Find that bastard. Make him pay.
I remember when Joker put her in that chair. But this?
No one's had any luck finding the cloudburst. It'd take us weeks to search this.
I don't mean to doubt you, Batman. It's just I see what we're up against, and I'm wondering if some more guns might be the answer. And a small thermal.
Guns are the weapon of the enemy. We do not need it. We will not use it.
She's really gone. She's dead.
I really like how all of the cops are maybe not just as, but are all affected by Barbara's death too. It really brings the sense of community that the cops of Gotham City have. And the way James Gordon is like, yeah, he's the commissioner, but the whole police force really is like its own little family too. And I guess that's always a minor theme with Batman in all incarnations.
Space is clear. Aerial drones are down.
I'll get our people back in the sky, Batman.
Is the theme of family, because obviously Batman's parents died and all that, and that's the inciting incident for what happened to him. And he's always got, you know, he's got the second family, his sidekicks. His Alfred, his Robin, his Nightwing, Catwoman's in there. James Gordon.
Riddler, tell me everything.
Screw you!
And it's even shown with the villains in their more favorable,
let's try that
interpretations.
Okay, okay, I'll talk.
There's usually a sense of loyalty between the villains and their henchmen. again, all things considered.